Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. This video I'm going to show you how to change your motor mount and transmission mount on the F10. This is a 2013 535. You can see behind me the N55 engine. It is a rear-wheel drive only, so this is not the all-wheel drive version. You will see later why it is way nicer to not have the all-wheel drive in this case, because it's just nothing in your way. I'll just walk you through what you need, the parts, part numbers, and also torx, and then we just flip it in and out. These are my engine mounts. You can see it's all hard plastic at the bottom, and there's nothing else to it. It's pretty simple and straightforward. This is important because I also seen hydraulic engine mounts. You have like a little silver spot, it's like the valve I connect to the hydraulic line, and they have a rubbery, like a rubber sheet at the bottom. So it's important to get the right part for your car, obviously. These should be easy, there's nothing to it. Since I do the engine mounts, let's also just do the transmission mount. They apparently are problems more often than not. So let's just walk through what you need and what you get if you buy. I bought the full set from FCP Auto. They sent me two, of course, like a left and a right motor mount, right? And again, this here, it's just plastic. Again, I've seen other ones, they have a like a rubber piece here. They are also bigger in the build-up and have like a little silver spot at one point where it connects to the hydraulic line. I can show you later how you would see that. But yeah, these are my mounts. Simple, straightforward. You can see it's connected here and 1, 2, 3 times there. That's it. Nothing more. This is all for motor mount. Right. Again, you have 1, 2, 3 on both sides, a 6, so you have 6 screws. They're a little bit different apparently. These are 13 millimeter hex. They will be torqued with 20 newton meters. And these are, I think, E14. Yep, E14. And you will torque these with 100. They go into the top here. And that's it. You will have to, of course, loosen them and jack the motor up. Otherwise, you won't get them out. Some part numbers here. 1, 2. I'll also drop the numbers in the description. But again, this is for my car. One look here. You can guess what it was here before. My educated guess is there was a BMW logo here, and they just removed that so they can sell it straight from the manufacturer without a branding. Comes a little cheaper for you. And this rubber piece is pretty much straightforward. You just unbolt it at the bottom, the top, flip it down. The nuts for the transmission mount are also 13 millimeter hex, and they are also 20 newton meter. So this is, as you can tell, the underbody in drive direction. So this is the front, this is obviously a transmission, and this appears to be your engine, your oil pan. This is the right side over here. You can see this is the hard side, right? You have a cat here, be careful. And this is your engine mount. I'm gonna remove this heat shield. There's just 2 screws here. I'm hoping to get a little bit more space here to take it out, but literally not much to it, right? It's your engine block. This is the holder for your mount. Up here, you can see the screw, the E14, you can see that up there. We have plenty of space to work. This is how it looks like. And then underneath here, there's one here. There's one in here, and there's one up here, and that is all. Loosen them up, it's not gonna go anywhere until you jack up the engine. Let's take a look at the other side. It's right here. Nothing to see, same thing. E14, and you see, like I mentioned, it just sits on top of the subframe. It's not going anywhere. This looks better though, obviously, huh? Like this is way higher up compared to over here. This is like all the way in. And if you happen to have the hydraulic ones, you would have to come from the side, right? From the side here, this black box is the engine mount. And you would see somewhere on top here, a little different, you would see a little line, a little hydraulic line. And that's pretty much, and you have to do a little bit more work. But in this case, this should be easy. It shouldn't take too long. Now, let's go back. This is your transmission holder. Zwei Transmission Aids. And up there, this is the transmission mount. And you just have like one here and one on top. You have to loosen these off, of course. And these six screws in here, apparently you also torque them with 20 Newton meter. Three more over there. Oh yeah, and obviously you have to remove the underbody paneling, right? This one up here is a huge pain in the ass. Best way I could figure out is loosening this heat shield. Then it go in from down here and pass it and fiddle it around. And then it can get your nut on there to loosen it. Once it's loose, you can use a smaller tool and things will become much easier. So fellas, quick update, I changed strategy after about an hour because this one wouldn't come out. Neither of them came out, so I decided to take off the carrier. There are four screws in there. It's the same E14 we have for the top one. These are supposedly torqued with 66 Newton meter. Three are easy to reach, one is a pain, huge pain. Anyway, now you can see, this is the old mount, and this is the new one. You can see how the old one is clearly further in, so-called collapsed. Also shows that if you're actually able to somehow get it out, you need some more wiggle room for the new one, because it's gonna be higher out. So, for me, taking off the carry arms is the way to go, at least for the, this is the passenger side, wish me luck for the driver side. So, passenger side, set this one in, and now you have to fiddle in the carrier, something like this. And then these with 60, this one with 100, and the three long ones with 20 each. Moving on to the transmission mount, you just have to stabilize the transmission. You don't have to pump it up, you just prevent it from dropping down when you remove the carrier. It's a 30 millimeter hex, three on this side, three on this side. Remove them, also the 13 in the middle for the mount. And then this is, the carrier comes down. You can access the nut on the top and change the mount. So, looking for this little nut up there, this one, also 13. So, you use a ring, 30 millimeter ring, and you can open the one at the top, comes out, also shows you the direction of travel. And now you just twist this out. You can see here, here. Excuse my light. Sticking it out and it comes out to the top. So I'm comparing the old one and the new one, and I can't really see a problem on this one here. The transmission mount seems fine, to be honest. Other than a few surface scratches somewhere on here, but nothing really problematic. Anyway, just drop in new one. Nothing really needed here. Check the dirt out. Just if the line is down here. That's it. Easiest. Now I'm only gonna attach one down here, so it's not going away. Fill it in. Clean this a little bit. And then torque them all down with 20 newton meter each. Another fun fact, this is a new one still. Nothing. Like you would expect it. This is the old one from the passenger side. It seems fine, flex-wise. Not much different than the new one. But this is interesting. So it's another day. Let's finish what we started. It didn't quite work out the way I intended it to. Simply because I couldn't check up the engine high enough. So I just ended up having to make space. What you can do in this case, either you lower the subframe, but then you have to hold the engine and you have to hold the subframe you're lowering. And I'm just not equipped for that. So the only other option I have then is make space towards the top side, which means removing the bracket that connects the engine mount to the engine. On the passenger side, that's somewhat easy. You have access from the bottom, luckily, because you don't have any from the top. However, on the driver's side, this is a little bit different. You don't really have, access, but I'm gonna get a light and I'll show you what the problem is here. So you see the engine mount down there in the center, there it is, right behind the charge pipe. You can't really reach the fasteners of the bracket that connects the engine mount to the engine, because there's one part above it. We'll show you later. But that part is blocking the access to the screws to the bracket. But that has to go. So in order to get there, since I can't reach it from the bottom, I have to make some space on the top to get there, which means the charge pipe has to go. That's in the way. For that, the air intake is in the way, the stiffening bars are in the way. Because I know that changing the charge pipe is a huge pain in the ass, I will remove the fan. You have to remove the bracket here, then you can take the fan out only so you have enough space. As you see here, the charge pipe connects here, and this is connected here to the fan. So only to give it a little bit more space, so you have wiggle room to take the charge pipe out a little bit more easier. And then with that out of the way, there should be enough space to reach the part that's in the way to finally access the engine mount bracket. For these stiffening bars, you need like a 16 millimeter down here and a 15 up there on the dome. Both sides, let's take it out. Stiffening bars gone. Next, just removing the cover, because I have to remove that anyway later on. So pull it. That's it. Just make sure you don't drop the little rubber grommets there. You can leave them in, but you also can take them out. I'll take them out. Let's remove the front bar. So first take these two out, take this out, you move the lip up a little bit. See that there are two more you have to take out, and you also can leave this rubber on here. With this out of the way, can just lift it up. Now you see there are two more and one down here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. They're all 13. You loosen those. So with this crossbar out of the way, we'll get to the fan later. But for now, we make some more space and remove the air filter housing. I'll remove back here, even use like a flathead or a 6mm. And these five are T20 Torx. And then all of this comes out. You will see a little knot down here. You can push if it gets stuck, but it should come out easily. So with the filter out of the way, don't forget to unplug your cables down here. It's just a wobble grommet, it just comes out. Three of them, more or less easy to take out, but not a big deal. And now you just have it sitting on these grommets here and down here. Just pull on it. Yeah. And another one. And this entire shebang comes loose. Just give it a wiggle. And there it is. Full on snorkel. So you remove these T30 down here and you disconnect the cables. And now there's just a little clip here. On the left side, just push it back and put it up. It's like hard to do with one hand. Just push it back and put it up, and the other one is down here, same thing. And then you can carefully maneuver the fan out. You just lift the fan a little bit and put it backwards so you can clear this nose here, right? And then you just take it out. Okay, fan is out, and as my luck has it, see here, there's supposed to be a little rubber grommet. You can find it on the floor. Down there it is. I'll get it later. Now we have access to the charge pipe. You have the clamp here. You have this connector down here with your sensor. You have this vacuum line. And of course you have your clamps here that connect. So with the charge pipe out of the way, now you can see the engine mount down there. It's easy to reach this bolt and the three that connect to the carrier from down. But if you want to loosen the arm, this heat exchanger is in the way. So there's one here and one on the other side to loosen this entire bracket. And that should give me enough wiggle room to loosen the arm and then finally take out the engine mount. So first I'm gonna loosen this part, heat exchanger, and then I have to drag it up and work from below. So with this heat exchanger out of the way, you have now access to one, there's another one up there, two, and there's a third one up there. These are holding your bracket, engine mount bracket in place. Just gonna loosen them carefully, and then I have to transition to below the car. Three screws holding the engine holder, or attaching the engine holder to the engine. Those are E18. For those that don't know what E is, it's a star, right? It's like an external Torx. Just loosen two of them to the front. I can't reach the one in the back yet, probably from below. With the car being jacked up, next thing is to remove all the under panels. Welcome to the underside. This is your oil level sensor. This is your oil pan. And your engine mount. Follow me. It's right here, this one. You have one, two, three, 13mm. We have up here, this is a E14 that holds the mount, connects the mount to the bracket, and the bracket two are already loosened. And this here is the third one, the E18. And then everything is loose. Before you do that, you want to stabilize the engine. So I'm just going to loosen them. It's going to be all somewhat loose, but it still holds. I'm only going to remove these three down here because gravity is my friend in this case. So with all the screws loose, I want to remove the two up here first, then the connection in between, and then the third one. And then the mount and the carrier is loose, and I can just take the pieces out. There you have it. Old engine mount, new engine mount. To be honest, it does not look that bad at all. It's about 3 to 4 millimeter collapsed. It's not all that bad, to be honest. But it is what it is, right? So now, just putting it back together. And that's also fun fact. You have a little groove here. This groove points towards the inside of the car, right? If you don't see that, the outside is closed, the inside is hollow. It's 100 newton meter for the screw connecting the motor mount to the bracket, and 20 43 screws that secure the mount to the subframe. Now this is done. Of course, you have to tighten the heat exchanger again, and then it comes to time to assemble things again. First thing, of course, is the chart pipe. Next thing will be the fan. Just make sure you hit your rubber grommet here and make sure you don't damage anything on the way going down. It's a little tight, but it's nothing complicated. With the fan back in, it's not much left. Make sure you got the connector right and you got the little 30 Torx down there in. That's pretty much it. Don't squeeze anything. Next thing, air filter housing, air filter. The rest is pretty straightforward and easy. Before you tighten the cross members here, make sure just give it a push so it is leveled again, because we had a car raised up. So there you have it. This is how you change your engine mount and transmission mount on a F10 N55. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.